snake bites your poison. Holy Ghost. What kind of God? They got ghosts, but they ain't got the Holy Ghost. Because when you got the Holy Ghost, you ought to be tender in heart. People ought to see the love that comes out of you. Even when they are guilty, you will make them feel like you. They'll make you feel like you're guilty. They will cover your sin.
We talked about holiness. And even possess the nature and the character of God. It's impossible. So what we do, what do we do? Let me say this and we get out of the way. What did we do? Listen, we tap into the law. It's not even conscious. Most church in the global, I'm talking about church in general, is preaching the law and grace at the same time. Not rightly dividing grace and not rightly dividing the law. They are preaching grace and the law the same. So legalism, they are saying, okay now. It is not good for a woman to preach. Oh, it's not good for a woman not to wear. Thank you. Oh, it's not good for a woman. We're supposed to bring deliverance, but it doesn't bring no deliverance. Because only the Holy Ghost can change you. I can tell you what to do, but until the Holy Ghost convicts you.
Hallelujah!
Through the Word, and it's the way we got to present the Word. The Word must be seasoned with grace. It cannot be judgmental, because if I be judgmental, I'm going to run you away.
Yeah.
He that win his soul must be.
Wow.
I'm not saying, I'm teaching the Word, and the Word will expose who you are. And if you want the Word to change you, then the Word will change you. So what we are not teaching that we have the gospel. Gospel. It's not gospel. You're mixing law with grace. You're bringing the people back under the law. And then the Bible says no flesh shall be justified by the working of the law. So when I bring you back under the law, and not even conscious what I'm doing, now you're trying to work up to maintain your righteousness. And don't even understand that your righteousness is filthy rags.
Amen.
It doesn't matter how good you are, you're still filthy rags if you ain't got his righteousness.
Amen.
So God set up in a way that we gotta come to Jesus.
Amen.
That if you're gonna glory, you're gonna glory in the Lord. Remember what Paul says? That means you ain't gonna glory in what you accomplish, you'll glory in the Lord. Because your righteousness is of the Lord. It's not of you. Your righteousness is filthy rags. It is filthy rags. Amen. It's filthy rags. Amen. It's filthy rags. Somebody say, no. Let the Holy Spirit modify the deeds of your body.
Let the Holy Spirit modify your body.
Because your body has many. Your body has many members. I'm coming to you right now. I sanctify and holy you might look. Not all of those members is lined up to the Word of God.
Amen.
I'm telling you, it's not lined up to the Word of God. This is why some things say to you that you find out you didn't have. I thought this already died. They was right there hanging around.
Yeah.
Just waiting for the right location. The right time to come out. Then it manifests when you find out that I'm still dealing with certain things
yeah.
that I thought I was delivered from.
Yeah.
It is through baptism into the death of Christ Jesus that bury the old man, that bury the old man. The old man need to be buried. The old man need to be buried. Next week I will deal with the loss of the eyes. And hopefully pride of life. Because I'm telling you, pride is a serious sin. Serious spirit. Pride? Pride will stop the hands of God from moving on your behalf. This is basically pride and always leading to iniquity. Because pride will make you think you got everything together when you don't. Pride will make you think you don't need no help from nobody. You got to help yourself. You don't need help, what I'm saying. Pride is a serious sin. The Bible says pride comes before a fall. Before you fall, you can stop being proud. Sometimes we don't know we're wrong until somebody else tells it. Yeah. And the root doesn't get to know your sins because that is not the spirit of God. That's not the spirit of God. And this is one of the sins that we caught a lot of people. A lot of people get fall victim to it, and they will pride in life. Marcus, you have somebody say how to say about that. Then you're gone. And when you say that, the talk to you will make you think that they got everything together.
Amen.
That they need help. Amen. When they need help. And that was the key. If that was the case, we don't need no help. Brother Glenn, if we don't need no help, God would make me and put me on an island by myself.
Amen.
Nobody. Hallelujah. Come on, isolate by myself. Heaven don't just open and put money in your hand. He says, man shall put in your bosom. See, even though God make the provision, but God use people.
Amen.
Lord, you hear what I'm saying.
Amen.
Do you ever see heaven open and a car drop from heaven? You ever seen a car drop from heaven? No. Do you ever see a house drop from heaven? No. God bless you two people.
Amen.
He bless you two people. And if you right there say, I don't need them, you will never have nothing. You run away your blessing.
That's
it. You know, if I live 1 million, this is one, you know.
One.
God can bring them here and they feel you.
Yes, Lord. Jesus, thank you, Lord.
That's enough to give the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Get to know you.
Yes.
Can I ask you?
Yes.
What you mean? Now, just remember, you cannot have no husband and a mind that no. Because that's what you need. Oh, you've been working by yourself own car. God wants to bless you through them.
Amen.
So God can continue to keep their flowing going.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Oh God. And they know it. Do you know the heathen?
Yes.
They understand the principle of giving better than the church. That's why you keep them. They keep coming more. That's the principle. Whether they're right or wrong, that's the principle. Give. So they give, and they get richer. And you hold it back, and they ain't getting them. And they give it, and getting richer. And then you get mad. But you ain't know what they're doing.
That's right.
You don't know what they're doing. They think they're better enough. But you don't know what they're doing. You ain't know the giving they're doing. Okay. You ain't know how they're taking care of orphans. You ain't know the order. The millions of dollars they're giving it and pumping into the system.
That's it.
So when God brings it back, don't get mad. They're operating in the principle. If you operate in the principle, the same God that